Okay, so going on to China and soft imperialization of Africa. I watched a documentary about in first year. It's quite interesting talking about how, you know, when China does an infrastructure project within an African country, they bring in a lot of Chinese workers. And the signs go up in Mandarin as well, which is really interesting. So what's going on over there?
So China, compared to other powers in the world, like Western world, they know how to create this neo-colonialism very quiet. So for example, as you said, they go there, they put their people there to work. For example, if it's a oil mine or like minerals, I think one country they work well is Sudan. I think Sudan. They go there, they construct their own small village, everyone from China is working there. They take all the oil, they take all the petrol, whatever they want. They bring it back to
China.
China.
Because just quickly, I know, I think when Iran trades sells oil to China, I don't think they actually buy it in money. They trade it with goods. And so that's quite an interesting dynamic as well. Purely because then Iran doesn't get like financial benefit, like direct money, where they can invest it. Instead, they'll it's like a trade, a bartering system, where like maybe they'll buy
Barter, yes.
I don't know, Chinese iPhone chargers or something. I don't know, but like stuff from China
Yeah.
essentially manufactured. Because China make insane amounts of stuff,
Yes.
like from mobile phones to Barbie dolls to you name it. It's probably made there. US
Everything.
USA flag.
Oh, might be.
American flags are made in China now. They make MAGA hats as well. There's
Yeah.
Trump MAGA hats are made in China as well.
You
It's like
see?
the funniest thing.
Connection. But the difference that China has is that, for example, if any, again, Western world with structural adjustment programs and World Bank and IMF, they put conditions and they give loans to the countries and they said open up the frontiers, the customs,
Yeah.
so everyone can go and, like, you know,
The sectors,
invest.
yeah.
So they invest in minerals, they make the money, all the international companies, and all the money go back to the home country.
So which
But
model? Okay.
no, but China, they don't put any conditions. They just say, we come, please, we take whatever we want, and we go back. So they don't put any sanctions, they don't put any regulations or
So they
conditions.
take it up front, basically.
Yeah, so they don't come to take everything in an ethical way. They just take it.
So which model do you think it's is worse? Would you say?
Both are worse for
But
sure.
like if I said to you, okay, you got to pick one of these. Which one would you say is more problematic?
What we see the situation in the world, the Western one, so far, it's creating many problems, it's creating dependencies, many economies collapsing because of the way it's structured. Chinese one definitely is not ethical as well because they
They're taking
exploit.
resources.
Yes, they exploit the resources, they
So
don't give
like
anything back to the
diamonds,
country.
oil, Africa is rich with many, many resources. One of the reasons
Yes.
why it was colonized, as well for such a long time is that it's full of diamonds.
Yes.